Good evening. I'm Sharon Rogers with the 6 o'clock KBAY News. Tonight's top story is taking place just north of town in North Fork, where Cory Publishing head, Mackenzie Cory, and his son James Frame are being held hostage by two gunmen in Cory's Northern Bay County cabin. Apparently, two other hostages are being held. They are identified as Cecile Frame, wife of James Frame, and Sandy Alexander, an employee of Cory Publishing. No motive for the taking of the hostages has been reported, and details of the incident are still sketchy. We have been told that the kidnappers have admitted a doctor into the cabin in order to treat a superficial gunshot wound suffered by one of the kidnappers. The doctor has been identified as Dr. Eric Holloway of Bay City General Hospital. Holloway was permitted to treat only the kidnapper's wound and then was ordered from the cabin. He has told authorities at the scene that Mackenzie Cory has apparently been shot, but that
Mackie's
he was not
been
allowed
shot. If anything happens,
no other information has been released. And at the present time,
why didn't they let the doctor in to see him? I mean, maybe he's dead.
No, Mrs. Cory, you mustn't think that. I'm sure he'll be all right.
Why didn't she say something about Jamie? She's not saying anything about Jamie.
Mrs. Cory, all we can do is pray that everything works out. I'm sure that the authorities up there are handling the situation.
I hope you're right. I'm so afraid for both of them. I wish I knew what was going on.
Larry, what do they want?
Come on, let's get away from Billings.
Go to my car.
Okay. They say they want a car with a full tank of gas. Want a safe passage to the airport, passports, planes gassed up and ready to go, and a pilot to fly them out of the country.
Oh, wait, that's a lot of stuff to get so short a notice.
I don't think I can get most of this at all.
Look, you have got to get me back in the cabin.
Rick, I don't want anything more than to get you back in that cabin, but I have got to work slowly. I can't do anything rash.
Look, it's very important that we find out what condition Matt Corey is in.
Now, Philip, there might be a way we can buy some extra time.
What do you mean?
Well, we make some demands of our own. And we don't start working on their list until they let Rick in to look at Matt.
Or at least we can tell them that's what we're doing.
Right, we'll get some extra time that way to work on this stuff.
I think that's worth a try.
Howdy. Name's Billings, Sheriff Billings. I'm in charge here. I can fill you in on what's happening.
Great. Just give me a few minutes to get set up, huh?
Good. Don't forget, name's Billings.
Right. Ross Nelson, KBAY News.
Pleased to meet you.
Look, I don't know what this clown's up to, but if he thinks he's turning this into a
three-way circus... Larry, let me take care of this. I'll take care of it.
Just get the people out of
here,
okay?
Larry, look. Look, I think we should go with your plan.
I don't know what else we're gonna do.
Man, if you don't get me in there soon, it's gonna be too late for Mac.
You know, you really can't let Mac die. I mean, then they really would get you for murder. Now, you don't want that, do you?
They're not gonna get me, sweet thing, not for anything. So don't you worry about it.
Well, then... In that case, why don't you let me go in and take care of Mac? That is, until you let a doctor back in to do a proper job.
What makes you think I'm going to let another doctor in here?
Well, aren't you going to?
Cecile, don't.
Hey, quiet down. I'm having a little conversation with your woman here. What's the matter? You got a problem with that?
Lenny, leave him alone.
Well, you want to take care of Mac? Is that what you want?
Yes, I do.
How bad do you want it, baby? You want me to let that blonde-haired doctor come in here and help you out a little bit? Is that what you want?
Yes, that's what I want.
Well, how bad do you want it, though?
I don't know what you mean.
I got a bunch of stupid people in here. Nobody understands a single thing that I say. How much? Exactly how much is it worth to you? Now, tell me, sweetheart. How much is it worth to you?
I don't know.
Anything to her.
Why don't we let this little lady here talk for herself?
Take your hands off of her.
Huh? Now tell me. How much is it worth?
Look, I really don't know what you mean.
Come here, man.
Take your hands off
of her. Get
James
takes care of you, buddy.
Okay, Lenny. I
think that's enough. You've made your point.
But it's all right for you, but not for me. Is that it?
And listen, sweets. If you want to see your husband here stay alive, just cut the cute stuff. You understand?
And now, the continuing story of Another World.
Is she all right?
Oh, yes, Mrs. Curry. I left Amanda trying to put together her new jigsaw puzzle.
I can't believe it. She's so grown up, and I've hardly spent any time with her.
Don't worry. I'm sure all that will change now.
I hope so. She's my little girl. She's all that I have left.
I'll get it.
News? Yeah, where's Matthew? Is he all right?
Well, he's all right. Clarissa's with him.
Well, what are we going to do, Mom?
The first thing you're going to do is calm down.
How can I be calm? Max's been shot.
I know, but you losing control of yourself isn't going to help.
Yeah, but somebody's got to do something.
Honey,
I mean, they just can't let them die.
Look, there are other people up there. Now, Rick Holloway is up there. If Mac needs medical attention, Rick will help him.
Didn't you listen to the news? They said that they wouldn't let Rick in to help him.
Please, Mrs. Cory.
Look. Louise, why don't you make us some tea, okay?
I don't want any tea. I just want to find out what's happening up at the cabin.
Honey, the minute there's any news, we'll hear. Go ahead, Louise.
This isn't good enough. I'm going up there.
Will you to the cabin? Just wait a minute and think sensibly.
I can't sit around and wait for news, Mom.
The last thing they need up there is somebody getting hysterical and getting in the way. Now, will you just please stay calm?
Don't you understand? It's Mac and Jamie who are up there.
If anything was going to happen to them, it would have happened by now. So hold on.
I just can't stand this. Why don't Larry or Rick call me?
Honey, the minute there is any news, they will call us. They'll call us if they can. Now, they have to move very slowly. Sounds like the kidnappers want something, and from the looks of it, they're holding all the cards.
You mean you knew about this? What did you find out?
Well, I only knew part of it. You see, Jamie actually never went to the Harold Clinic.
What do you mean he never went to the clinic?
Sandy Alexander went instead. Jamie went up to Mac's cabin to rest.
I don't understand. How could they pull a switch off like that?
I guess it was easy. You see, Jamie was supposed to check himself into the clinic. So he sent Sandy instead. Then he went up to the cabin. The kidnappers were after Sandy, and that's who they thought they'd captured. Of course, Mac knew as soon as he looked at the picture that it was Jamie, so he got the ransom money together and went up there. He came back to get more money, and that's the last I heard.
Well, they just said on the news that someone's been injured, so something must have gone wrong somewhere.
I had so hoped this would all be over.
Alice, who else knew about this?
Well, the only one that I spoke to was Russ.
Why, Russ?
Well, you see, the doctors at the Harold Clinic called Russ to let him know that Jamie had left without their consent. Well, you know how worried Russ was about Jamie's condition.
So you told Russ about the switch?
I had to. He would have called the police.
I wish he had.
I wish he had, too, now. But the kidnappers threatened to harm Jamie if the police were brought in.
So Russ knew about this?
Yes, he did.
Okay, fellas, let's set up for a rehearsal, eh?
Yes.
I don't believe the people they have out there.
Yeah, Lenny, I don't like this at all. We've got to get out of here before it's too late.
They know what we want. Either we get it or they don't get what they want.
Lenny, would you move away from that window? I don't want them to know we're worried about all those people they've got out there.
You know, you guys might as well face it. There's no way you're getting out of here.
Now, why don't you keep your mouth shut, kid? See, you better hope we get out of here, because if we don't, you don't make it either.
Hey, Lenny, why don't you talk to him? Maybe that cop would make that deal now.
I don't know. Yeah, enough time went by to work on our demands. You ready to talk out there?
Everybody down. I don't know what they're up to. We're not ready to talk to you yet.
You're not ready to talk? You better get ready to talk, or you want to see these people alive again.
Okay, listen, we got your list of demands. We're working on them. These things take time.
You don't have the time. You better move it, or I'm going to do something bad in here.
Look, we're not even going to start working on these demands until you let a doctor come in there and see Mac.
Lenny, you don't have any bargaining power at all. If Mac's dead, why don't you let him send a doctor in?
I don't remember asking for your opinion, kid.
Oh, Lenny, leave him alone. Besides, maybe he's right.
Whose side are you on, anyway?
Look, we can't let Cory die. He's no good to us dead.
I don't like them dictating the terms. I want to do it my way.
I know, Lenny, but look, if we let them have a little bit to say in this, then we're a lot more likely to get the terms we want.
She's right, Lenny. Listen to her.
I told you to stay out of it, and I meant it.
Jamie, maybe this is one decision they ought to make on their own.
Now, look who's making some sense for a change. The mouth.
Hey.
All right, maybe you have a point. We'll do it their way. All right, send the doctor in here, but don't try anything funny. If you try one thing funny, I'm going to start killing people.
All right, you ready, Rick?
Yeah, I'm ready.
Where are you going there?
I got an idea.
What kind of idea?
What you got on your mind now, Billings?
I was thinking that medical kit would make the perfect place.
Perfect place for what?
A gun, of course.
A gun?
Hey, man, wait. I don't like this one bit.
Look, you've already been in there once, right? You didn't try anything then, so now they trust you.
There is no way I'm going in there with a gun. First of all, I think it's a lousy idea. And secondly, there's no one in there capable of using it.
I meant for you to use it yourself, kid.
I've never used a gun in my life. I wouldn't know what to do with it if you gave it to me.
Look, maybe you could slip it to Sandy. I know he knows how to use a gun. And from what you tell me, he might be the only hostage who's able to do anything.
I really don't like this idea. What happens if he searches the bag? I could get us all killed.
Look, Doc, this might be our only chance. We've got to take them by surprise, and they trust you.
Oh.
Look, your friend here, he agrees it's a good idea.
Look, only if Rick wants to do it. But I don't think it's a sure thing. It just might work, though.
No. There is no way I'm going to jeopardize seeing Jamie and Mac. They need medical attention. Look, man, I'm a doctor. That's my responsibility. This is your job.
Okay, Rick, if you don't want to do it, I agree with you.
Hey, now, hold it a minute. Listen, it's going to work. Look, if they go into your bag, you use the gun. And if they don't, you slip it to Alexander.
All right, Billings.
In any case, no matter what happens, we'll be in there in 5 seconds.
He said he didn't want to do it. Now, he doesn't have to do it. Now, let's get him in there before they start wondering what's happening.
Gun.
All right, the doctor's coming in.
Said anything new.
Well, they have to move carefully. They don't want to take any chances.
I just don't understand why they've let it go on this long. Hello?
Hey, it's me.
Where are you?
I'm in the police station. I might have some news.
What?
Well, it's not good. Mac's apparently been shot. They're still holding on to Jamie and Cecile and Sandy.
Well, I know that. Don't you know anything else?
I know Rick Holloway is there. I know that they let him in, but he didn't get to treat Mac. Evidently, he took care of one of the kidnappers' wounds.
I know that, too, but why wouldn't they let him in to treat him? I mean, it might be too late.
Look, I don't know, but I'm sure they'll let him in there as soon as possible.
They've got to do it sooner than that. It'll be too late, and he'll be dead. They've got to do something now.
Hey, don't do that to yourself. Just let the police take care of it.
If anything happens to Mac or Jamie, I don't know what I'd do.
Are you there alone?
No. Mom and Louise are here.
Okay. Good. I don't want you to be there alone.
Well, when are you coming back?
As soon as I can. Now, just calm down. It's not going to do any good to get worked up over this.
They can't let him die. They've got to do something soon.
I'm on my way home.
Okay, I'll see you soon.
Did he have any news?
No, nobody knows anything. I just can't stand any more of this.
Look, there's nothing any of us can do.
I'm not so sure about that. I think there's something we can do.
Oh, Mrs. Cory, I'm so sorry about the tea. It took so long, but I was listening to the news on the radio, and the tea kettle boiled over on the stove. I wasn't watching it.
Was there any news?
Yes. They've let the doctor go back inside.
They're treating Mac's wound. You see, I've got to go up there.
You're going up to the cabin, Miss
No,
Cory?
She's not.
Yes, I am.
You've got to stay here and wait. There's probably a roadblock up there anyway.
Oh, Mrs. Cory, I think your mother's right. It would be better if you stayed here with Amanda.
Mitch is coming soon. I'll ask him.
Look, will you stop being so stubborn and listen? There's nothing you can do up at that cabin anyway. Mitch will tell you the same thing.
Maybe. But maybe not. Maybe I should go up there. I just don't know what to do.
Come on, get in here. Hurry up.
Can I see Mac now?
Wait a minute. Let me see the bag.
What? You think I got grenades in there or something?
Yeah. You got enough junk in here, don't you?
This is a toothache we're talking about. There's a man seriously wounded.
Hey, cut the cute stuff. Let's go. Come on.
Right. Mac, can you hear me? Are you awake?
Sorry.
No, Mac, it's Rick. Rick Calloway.
Yes.
No, don't try to get up. You're going to be fine.
Sandy, all right.
Yes, Mr. Cory, Sandy's fine, and so is Jamie. Mr. Cory, do you know where you are?
Cabin. Sandy and Jamie.
They're okay. Everyone's okay. Yeah. Mr. Cory, I'm going to take your jacket out from under you. Just relax. I'm going to make you more comfortable. That's it. That's it. Just relax.
Come on, Doc. Hurry up, will you?
Yeah, just take it easy. I'm going as fast as I can without causing him any more pain.
I don't care how you do it. Just do it. Come on, we don't have enough time.
I know that.
Hey, you. You talking to me?
Yeah, I'm talking to you.
What is it you'd like?
I want you to stand up. Now go out into the kitchen and get me something to drink, which is something cold. It is too hot in here.
I can't do that very well with my hands tied.
Oh, isn't that a shame? Look, I asked you, cutie, to do something, and I expect you to do it. And you'll just have to figure out a way to do it with your hands tied, won't you? Make it into a little game.
How fun.
Oh, it will be fun. Because I know you like games, don't you? Like the one you were playing with Lenny a little while ago? Now move it. Oh, don't try anything cute while you're out there. Because I've still got these two in here, remember?
Jamie.
It's taken to the doctor so long.
I don't know, man. Just think of it as a good sign, okay? So are you sure you're all right?
Yeah, where's Cecile?
She's in the kitchen.
Sandy.
Yeah?
When you took Mac into the bedroom, how did he look?
Not good. You don't look so terrific yourself, you know.
No, I'm worried about Mac. Is he going to be all right?
I don't know.
Is he going to die?
I really can't say for sure.
What do you think?
I said I don't know.
How serious are his wounds?
Look, I don't know. Can we just not think about
it? You gotta think about it. Do you think he's so serious that it might kill him?
Why don't we just wait for Rick? Why don't we just wait for the doctor to get back out here, all right?
I thought you might be able to tell me something.
Look, I'm no doctor.
Yeah, well, I thought with all the experience, you know, you've had in Las Vegas and all, you've had experience with gunshot wounds. What do you think?
Well, I don't know what to think. I mean, Mac has taken a bullet in the chest, and he's not a kid anymore. He's lost a lot of blood, and yeah, maybe he's gonna die. Now, is that what you're so damn anxious to hear?
Die?
Look, I'm sorry, Jamie. I didn't mean to jump down your throat.
Yeah. You know, it's a heat. It's place, you know. I think it's affecting all of us.
Yeah, I guess maybe you're right. Let's change the subject.
No, I can't. Mac, my father is in there. And I'm afraid.
Look, I'm afraid too, okay? He's my...
What?
He's, special to me, too. I mean, I just don't want anything to happen to him.
I know. He dies. I killed him.
What?
Me and my brilliant idea.
What are you talking about? You didn't do anything.
I should have gone to clinic myself. Oh, but I had to come up with this clever scheme.
Look, let me tell you something. Those people were after me. So if anything happens to him, I'm to blame.
Now, you didn't drag Mac up here. Now, come on, Sandy.
Look, Jamie. If you're thinking about taking off on some kind of guilt trip, you're way off base. I'm the one who's responsible for that gunshot wound. Mac took a bullet that was meant for me. Now... he saved my life. And in doing that, he may have given up his own. So if anything happens to him, it's me that has...
How is he?
Is he okay, Doc?
He's stable now. He's lost a lot of blood.
Can you do anything for him?
I don't know. I have to go outside and see what supplies we may have.
Hey, where's the little lady?
What? She's out in the kitchen, getting me a drink.
You trust her alone out there?
Oh, Lenny, her hands are tied. She isn't going to do
anything. I'm going to go check her out.
Doc, what do you think his chances are? I'm not sure. Look, are you okay?
Yeah.
You mind if I check him out? I don't like the way his cough sounds.
Look, I don't care much what you do if you just shut up and make it fast.
All right. You don't look too good. Hurts. I bet it does. How long you been coughing up blood?
I don't know. I think I've lost track of time.
Well, I'm going to tape it up. Just for the time being.
Will he be okay once he gets the blood?
Well, it certainly give him a better chance. You mind if I untie his hands while I'm taping him up here?
You think I'm running a clinic around here? You leave his hands tied and just do the best you can.
Yes, sir.
Doctor,
What if he doesn't get the blood?
I don't even want to think about that right now. All I can say is, if he does get the blood, give him a considerably better chance.
Well, it doesn't sound too good. I wish there was something I could do.
Well, for starters, you can lie down while I finish this.
No, it's okay. I can sit up.
No, really, I want you to lie down. I want you to lie down.
Listen, right. Jamie, you know, this guy's a doctor. Maybe you ought to do what he says. So why don't you just lie down there?
Go ahead. You're going to be just fine. You just lie still.
Listen, Doc, thanks for taking a look at him. I mean, I really felt like he could use the attention, you know?
Yeah. Listen, you're okay.
Yeah, I'm fine, Doc.
What are you doing, Doc?
Well, I'm just checking a few things out. I've got to go outside and get some more supplies. I'll be right back.
Yeah, that's about to let you back.
Yeah, well, in the meantime, someone should stay in there with Mac.
Yeah, okay, you. Hey, go out there and sit with the old man till he gets back.
Change of scenery.
Still got your smart mouth.
All right, you got 1 hour to get that stuff and get back here. You got it?
I need more than an hour. It takes at least 2 hours to bring the stuff up from Bay City.
3 hours! That's it.
Thank you ever so much. Well, I'll see you later.
Hey, Doc.
Thank you, Doc.
Yeah? I got a message for your friends out there.
Yeah?
You tell them we mean business, okay? Mm-hmm. Now, they know what we want. As soon as Cory gets treated in there, we want exactly what we asked for. You got it?
I got it.
And you tell them that if we don't get what we want, I'm going to start killing these people in here one by one. I'm not kidding.
It's going to be okay.
Yeah, I do. I think they know they have to cooperate if they want to get out of there alive.
What if Mac dies or
Joey,
is dead?
Joey, come on.
No, wouldn't
I don't
that,
want to think about it.
Wouldn't that change the whole thing?
Yeah, I guess it would.
All right, and so if that happened, what would happen?
Joey, I don't
know. Listen. Probably spending all their time with the doc now. This is the time for us to make our move.
No, it's going to blow all our chances.
Look, this is the only chance we're going to have to take them by surprise.
Look, if anything goes wrong, Rick's life is going to be one more that we've lost. Now, I want those people alive. Rushing in there is not going to do it.
This is Ross Nelson, KBAY, reporting to you live from the cabin of Mackenzie Cory, North Fork, Northern Bay County. There is an incredible amount of tension here as we wait for Dr. Eric Halloway to come out of the cabin. The kidnappers allowed Dr. Halloway to enter the cabin to examine Mackenzie Cory, who reportedly has been shot. Everyone here is waiting for Dr. Halloway to return from the cabin and give us the report on how Mr. Cory is faring and also give us word on the news of the other hostages, James Frame, Cecile Frame, and Sandy Alexander. Halloway was permitted to enter the cabin after the kidnappers were told by the local police that their demands would not be acted upon unless there was some assurance that the hostages were still alive. The doctor is still in the cabin, and everyone outside is waiting anxiously for his report. As soon as there is any further word on the situation, we will be back with another live report, and now we continue with our regular programming.
This is driving me crazy. I can't listen to it anymore.
I just don't understand how they could have let Rick go in there alone.
He's in as much danger as the rest of us.
And how Russ could even have let him and Joey go up there in the first place?
I heard what Alice said. He couldn't tell them what he knew.
But there had to be some way to stop them. He knew what kind of trouble they were walking into. And now Rick is up in that cabin with his life possibly in danger.
He didn't have a choice. The kidnappers warned him against going to the police.
Yeah. Well, it just seems like Russ could have made up some excuse, something, to keep Rick and Joey here.
Why did Joey have to go, too?
Hey, look, he just went with Rick. I mean, they didn't know what they were going to find when they got there.
Anything happens to either one of them.
Listen to me. Kit, don't think about it, please.
What are we going to do?
I guess there's just not much anybody can do except pray they'll be all right.
I'm so worried about Greg.
So am I. But can't think about it. Okay. Well, look, why don't we just go back to work and hope for the best.
A report from North Fork indicates that Dr. Eric Holloway has gotten inside the cabin in which the two kidnappers hold Mac Cory, his son and daughter-in-law, and Sandy Alexander, a Cory publishing employee. Stay tuned to this station for immediate updates on this fast-breaking story.
Shut that thing off.
How else are we going to know what's going on?
We are what's going on. Shut it off.
Hungry.
Go eat.
There isn't anything. We're about out of coffee. Oh, so hot.
This ain't no resort. Shut up about it.
How are you doing?
Okay.
What's about if I help you sit up?
No, I feel a lot better if I lie down.
Get away from him.
Just seeing if he's all right, Lenny.
Why doesn't anyone ever check on me?
Oh. You got a problem?
Yeah, I'd like something to drink.
There isn't anything.
Quit complaining. And you, Big Mouth, you don't deserve anything. Get away from him.
Hey, no, really, I really would like something to drink. You know, it is hot in here.
Hey, would you do something to shut these two up?
Okay. Okay.
Well, if it ain't Florence Nightingale.
How is it?
Cecile, what's the matter?
Sandy, I really think Mac is dying.
What happened? Hey, get the doctor back in here.
Don't worry about it. He'll get here when he gets
here. Hey, Cecile, look, calm down. Tell me what happened.
Nothing happened, but someone has to do something. I really don't think Mac's going to make it. Unless he gets help right now.
Oh, see, Rick, what did you find out? Can we make a move?
Dr. Holloway, can we get your comments?
Look, would everybody just be quiet? Give him some room. We're going to hear what he has to say. Just let him talk. All right, what'd you find out?
Mac's got a serious gunshot wound to the chest. Now, he's alive, but he needs medical attention, and he needs it now.
Is he going to make it?
I don't know that. I did what I could, but the circumstances aren't the best.
All right, what can we do?
Well, he's going to need blood, and he's going to need more treatment of the wound.
How much time we got?
I don't know that either. The quicker he gets to the hospital, the more
chance... I say we move in there right now. I don't want to risk any more people than we already have.
Look, you do that and we lose a lot of lives. I say we wait.
What about Mac? He doesn't have much time.
No, Rick, the truth. Realistically, what are his chances? If we get him to the hospital right away, he stands a chance.
What if he stays in there?
Doesn't look good, Larry. Doesn't look good at all.
Thank you.
I'm really stiff. Can I walk around a little?
No.
No.
Stay
these,
there.
These bandages, they're really tight. I just need to move around just a bit. Really. That's so I can breathe. I can't.
Yeah, sure. It's okay. But I'm going to be watching you, so don't try anything.
Thank you.
Okay?
Yeah.
Get him up!
Sure, Lenny. Right away. Come on. Up you go. Yeah, listen, Lenny, think it'd be okay if I, put him on the couch? Yeah, all right. You'll be all right?
Yeah.
I'm going to the cabin.
Look, they've got their hands full up there. It's going to be dangerous.
Look, you don't understand. I have to go up there. I have to be with my son.
It's more than that, isn't it?
I can't stand being around here anymore. I don't know what's going on if I were to go up there.
You're just putting your life in danger, and I don't want to think of that.
Okay, but I'll be careful.
What can I do to talk you out of it?
Nothing. I just have to do this.
Is your mind made up?
Yes, it is. Please understand.
All right, if you're going to go, just be careful. If anything happens to you...
Please, don't worry. I'll be all right.
I just don't want to see you get hurt. I don't want you to go.
Maybe I shouldn't go. I don't know what to do.
Look, I love you. I don't want to see you get hurt.
Got everything?
Yeah. I just wish that blood would get here.
Where do you think you could be?
I don't know.
Well, maybe they got lost. You know, that road's pretty hard to see in the dark.
I don't know how much more time we've got. Mac needs that blood, and he needs it now.
Look, all we can do is wait and hope for the best.
Larry?
Yeah?
When I was examining Mac, I found a gun.
Did anybody see it?
No. I managed to get it off him and slip it to Jamie.
So Jamie has it now?
Jamie has it now. I don't know if he's capable of using it, but I thought maybe he could pass it to Cecile or Sandy. I hope I didn't do the wrong thing.
No, I don't think he did. I don't know.
Things were so hopeless. When I saw the chance to try and help, I didn't know what else to do.
I just hope you didn't put him in more danger, though.
What do you mean, more danger?
Well, if those kidnappers see a loaded gun, they may not wait for their demands. They might just go ahead and kill them all.
That doctor has less than an hour to get here. I don't think he's going to come back in.
He'll be back.
Yeah, sure. How long you been married to the kid, honey?
About 6 months.
Oh. Hey, you're newlyweds.
Not exactly. Lenny, leave her alone.
Mind your own business. Cecile, isn't it? Well, Cecile, why don't you come over here? Huh? Come on, honey. Come on over here.
Lenny, why don't you leave her alone? She's scared enough as it is, okay?
I'm not planning on scaring her, Alexander.
Oh, you're a big man, aren't you, creep?
I'd watch my mouth if I was you.
Oh, you would, huh? Just leave the lady alone, all right?
What are you so interested in all this for anyway, huh? Come on, honey. Come on over here. I'll make sure your husband stays healthy.
Don't.
Shut up. Get over here, little lady. Put your hands up. Out. Now, Cecile, I want you to rub my neck and shoulders. You're getting sore and stiff from waiting for your doctor friend to show up. Hey, watch the shoulder, huh?
Sorry. Is this better?
Yeah, that's good. You got real talented hands, honey. Yeah, that's a real good start.
Can I sit down now, please?
Oh, not so fast. You got great taste in women, kid. At least most of the time.
Sit down.
Okay. Come here. Go!
All right, Lenny, that's about enough of that now. Okay, Hannah, Now, don't either one of you make a move, all right?
Well, now, it looks like we have an entirely new situation, doesn't it?
Join us each weekday at this time for the continuing story of Another World.